Hello, and welcome to this MySQL QA series. In this series, we have about 13 episodes, which will touch on nearly every aspect of MySQL quality assurance. Hi, my name is Roel Van de Paar, and I currently work for Percona. I've been involved in nearly every aspect of MySQL QA for about 4 years. In the first episode, we'll have a look into Linux, Bash, scripting, etc. It will be very interesting, even if you're not particularly interested in quality assurance, to review this episode. It will be a bit longer than the other ones, and it will go into quite some depth. It will start off easy with simple commands like ls and cp, but then we'll move into more serious items like exargs, for loops, while loops, etc. etc. In the second episode, we'll start building a MySQL server. If you've never built before, this might be very interesting for you. CMake, make, git, compiling, using build tools, etc. The third episode is starting to veer towards serious QA. We'll have a look into how we can use GDB to get a backtrace from a core dump, how we look at frames, what library dependencies are, etc. By then, we'll probably be ready to get our framework set up. As you probably noticed in a recent blog post, we've released a pquery framework. We'll have a look at how to get pquery, we'll have a look at what reducer does, etc. Then, we're ready to set up our QA run. We'll look at MTR to SQL, pquery run, etc. Once our QA run is done, we'll let it run over a night or so. We need to have a look at the results. pquery-prep-reducer, pquery-clean-known, and pquery-results come in very handy here. As we go through these stages, we're also trying to show how to use the new pquery framework, which we're now using instead of the random query generator, which was developed by Philip Stoof. How this fits together and how it works. pquery itself is a simple binary, but we build a framework around it, and we find it to be more suitable to do exhaustive testing on MySQL. After this, of course, we might have generated many bugs and many cores, but how do we go about reporting these to developers? Well, for this we need test cases. So the reducer program, which has been growing over the years, has many different options. So there are three different episodes that go from very simple, single-threaded simplifications to more in-depth tuning, how you can be better at reproducing bugs, to, in the ninth episode, very advanced multi-threaded simplification. Then, in episode 10, we look more in-depth into how can we make sure that we reproduce certain bugs? How can we simplify certain bugs? It's not necessarily that hard to trigger a bug, but reproducing the same and simplifying the same, especially if it's multi-threaded, is very complex. Or it can be very complex, but with the right explanations and tools, it's not necessarily that hard. Okay, then in episode 11, we'll have a short look at valgrind testing, especially why. Why do we want to do valgrind testing? We've got maybe somewhat of a unique perspective on that. Have a look later on when it's available. In episode 12, we'll also have a short look at to multi-node cluster testing using Docker. Maybe not directly relevant to everybody, but you might be interested in this if you've been looking into Docker or you've been looking into Percona cluster, and maybe there are some items that you can pick up from this. In the final episode, we will sort of show a little bit of what our vision is for MySQL regression, stress, and feature testing. We'll look into random coverage testing or random spread coverage testing and SQL interleaving. If these things are done in a consistent way, then MySQL quality assurance takes on a very different dimension. I hope you enjoy the series. I hope you enjoy the work that went into it, not just from me, but from all the people who have contributed to the pquery framework, to the bug reports, to teaching me and others along the way, etc. I also thank my employer, Percona, for allowing the time to get this all set up for you. I hope you enjoy it.